Hey besties! I don't know anyone who hasn't fallen in love with these cute little morbid characters lately. So here's my take on some dumb ways to dye nail art. If you'd like to use a protective base on your nails, then apply that first. Otherwise, start with some base colors. I didn't have some of the colors that I needed, so I had to mix my own. Paint your base coat till it's completely opaque. The colors we're using match the backgrounds from the video. Each little guy has their own color, so if you choose to do different characters, you'll need to work that out. Otherwise, you can just paint yours the same colors that I painted mine. Sell both your kidneys on the internet. We're going to be using acrylic paint to paint the characters. For all of them, start with a color that matches, then apply details in a slightly darker shade. For the kidney fellow, we start with, of all things, a kidney shape. Then add some little legs with feet and arms to hold a wad of cash. Now for the details. First off, he needs a fistful of money in green and then a cool scar in red. He has a big cheesy grin in white and then black dots for eyes with tiny little white highlights. Ta-da! I also give him a dark circle to stand on for some added dimension. Once it's all dry, give it a coat of clear. Stand on the edge of a train station platform. I ended up redoing this guy because I didn't like how he turned out. But start with an egg of pink for the body with arms and legs. He's got some fluffy yellow hair and I used some dark pink for the shading. A red headphone cord and a black dot for his mouth. In the redone version, I added a train station platform and made him a little bit smaller so he fit better on my nail. Use your private parts as piranha bait. This one's my favorite. He's only half a kidney shape because this guy knows how to have fun. So start with a light pink, then the details are a circle below him as well as his eyebrows and lower lips. His face is a big scared mouth with two little eyes. For his bones, add a spine, then a figure eight for his hips, some legs and ribs in white. Don't forget to add the water. And some biting fishies in red. Oh no, it's my junk! Some little black eyes for the fish. Poke a stick at a grizzly bear. This guy is like the other half, a piranha boy. They're half a jelly bean shape with little arms and legs. Give him a darker blue shadow for some dimension and a poking stick. Some pink for his exposed wound. You also need a bear to poke in brown. Last but not least, you need a dot of white for his spine and a little fountain of blood in red. Don't poke the bear! Get your toast out with a fork. This guy is just a sad little skeleton. So a round face with a spine, figure eight for his hips, couple of hoops for ribs, and two lines for arms. Now some black for the ashes. Fork, toast the lever, and his sad, sad face. He really wanted that toast, you guys! Finally, add the rest of the toaster and a frown in gray. Use your clothes dryer as a hiding place. First, let's do the clothes dryer. My right thumbnail is really small, which is why I chose it for this nail. So do a simple circle in white and then another circle in purple. Black for eyes and a frown that immediately regrets its hiding spot. Once again, some highlights for the eyes, and this is the only dummy who gets teeth. Take your helmet off in outer space. This guy is just a big red blob, so let's start with that. Then give him a gray space suit, line back to the ship, and a helmet. Now add the details. Some dark gray shadows on the suit and helmet, then two white lines to finish it off. While you have your white art, you might as well give him some bulging eyes. Dress up like a moose during hunting season. This guy requires a bit of space, so save him for a big nail. So first, paint some stripes on to be the background of the forest. Once it's dry, paint on a green blob with little string arms. Then add a helmet in dark green and details in the same color. How are you guys at painting with your left hand? I could use a little more practice. Let's add some glorious antlers so everyone totally buys that he's a moose. Some entry wounds in red. I went over the face in black, but in the end I redid the whole nail. Again, not so great left-handed. Invite a psycho killer inside your house. The psycho killer is a big oval of green with a darker green oval inside. Use the same dark green for his arm, then top it off with a dark brown blob. He's got a big white hockey mask that goes over most of the dark green circle. And three white claws. Three lines on the outside of the mask, then just fill in the middle with eyes and random black dots. Eat a tube of super glue. Super glue dude is just a big round circle. Clearly he needs to lay off the super glue. Paint his legs in a darker shade, then add a cute little smile and some eyes. Lastly, add the super glue. And there you have it. I hope you guys enjoyed this tutorial. Of course, once you've got cute nail art like this, you totally have to do the dance. As Metro says, be safe around trains. Thanks so much for watching.